Welcome, basketball fans, to a very special Veterans Day edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, along with Greg Anthony and Brett Beard. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. We've got the visiting team and the home team. Here's B-Train, now the starting group for the visitors. G out there with Smith. And it's Smith. And there's the bulldozer. And it's the general in at the five, patrolling the paint. Here's Ramsey. High shot from 10 feet out.
And drawing first blood, you know coach likes that momentum out of the gate.
Well, for us, it'll be interesting. Can they keep that kind of pace up all game long?
Pass to D. Smith on the wing. Inside, shot clock at six. Here's D. That's no good. Couldn't get his first shot to go. Passes it to Ramsey. It's hauled in by Watson. And just about a minute into the first quarter. Smith, the pass to the general. Stolen by Fresh. One-on-one fast break. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Beautiful transition offense there. That's execution at its best.
Yeah, once you burst through a seam like that, you got to look right towards the rim. Sweet play.
Smith, the pass to D. Here's the general. Launches it. No good. Shot missing. Now here's Fresh. Not a lot of room. And the pass to B-Train. Thunder passes to Ramsey. No good. That's miss number two. He's one for three. Smith dishes to Smith. A fader. That shot missing. Here's B-Train. That one wide left.
With nobody getting a hand in his face in that painted area, that's a miss he's going to be disappointed with.
Stripped it away. Here's the break. Ahead. Finished off the break. B-Train's got his second bucket.
And that's the kind of play you just do not want to give up defensively. You lose the possession and give up a quick two at the other end. Trying to snap them out of this little slump.
Well, they can't find the net right now, and all they need, I think, is just to get one to go, get back on track.
B-Train's gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Smith surveying the D. Pass to the general. Smith outside. Passes to D. Can they get it? Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
Here's B-Train. That one off the back iron and out. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. D off target at the rim.
Really just struggling here in the first few minutes. 5 attempts with only one falling.
B-Train passes to T. And it's good. 2 points.
Assist from B-Train.
Now Smith. No points in the game yet for him. To the inside. Nothing that time. He's 0 for 2.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough. That's just tremendous scoring instinct. So fun to watch him work in the half court.
Smith right side to the paint. Misses in close.
Well, that's how to protect the rim without fouling. Force him into an awkward release and a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
And the professor picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Benson, covered by Smith. Here's Benson to the wing on the left, Edwards. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
Edwards. Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
And here's Brown. Pass to Smith. To the middle. And he dunks it down.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope. His only concern right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points. Now here is Edwards. 1:46 left to play in the first. The pass to Smith. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Shoots. He's good with the little jumper in close.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
Smith against Smith. On the wing, Brown. Pass to Pinson. Back to Brown. Now here is Smith, guarded closely. And that one's off. And this is his first shot of the game.
And, Kevin, they need to be consistent with their effort on the boards. You look at the box score, and they're at a definite disadvantage.
Now here's Edwards. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Edwards got his second basket of the game.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Smith outside. He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Prime time, the pass to Pinson.
Yeah, the defender all over.
This is the fundamentals. That's his first personal foul.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Pinson. Taking two shots.
First one falls for him. So he picks up just one from the line that time. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. To the inside, Mr. Fundamentals. And he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were 4 or 5 boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked 6. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
Here's Pinson. Smith outside. With one on the clock. No good on the last second attempt there. And so it's the home team up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, dance team.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. Guys, what's your take on the home team so far?
On the attack right from the tip. They've been relentless offensively.
Well, just taking it right at the opposition and the other team right now. No answers and no way to slow them down.
Here's Pinson. We've got Brown. Smith is out there with the closer. And it's prime time. And it's Smith in at the power forward.
Smith.
On Wednesday, they'll start out on the road and play the Lakers in Los Angeles. Then on Friday, they'll go back home and they'll be hosting the Boston Celtics.
And Kevin, I think you have to look at this as an opportunity to take a step forward. Sometimes tough road trips can bring the best out of a team and bring you closer together.
The first free throw is good. He hits both from the stripe. Edwards with it. Passes it to Benson. Smith kicks to McCallum. Out to the right wing. Now here's Edwards. Buries the long-range jumper. Edwards got 7 points in the game.
He's going to punish you, Kevin, if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
Pass to Pinson. Brown outside. Here's Pinson. Lock at six. Smith on the wing. Edwards defending. Smith's shot is good. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. Edwards passes to Benson. Here's McCallum, covered by Smith. The pass to Edwards for three. That one misses. His first miss of the game after making his first three. Down low, and down it goes. Dunked through off a wonderful assist.
They've worked hard to get this lead. Can't start giving up easy slams all of a sudden.
Yeah, GA, that's right. And that was easy. Gift wrap for him.
So much talk about 48 minutes. The team with the lead letting its guard down now.
That's no good, and he's 3 for 5. Brown outside. Smith trying to break loose, and it's Brown missing. 2 minutes now played in the second quarter. Let's it go from 14. McCallum misses. Brown feeling it out a bit. Kicks to Smith. Back to Brown. Smith outside. 5 to shoot. Over Edwards. And it's Smith missing. Smith's gotten just one of his 4 attempts from the floor tonight. And it's Smith penetrating. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
And Matador defense. That's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
And coach can't be happy, and I think I know why. Their defense putting up no resistance inside.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring, and if you can get to a high efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
Here's the general. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Pass to D. Here's the general. Six to shoot. Here's D. Offline with his three.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
Chalk up two there. And that's now 6 points for Jay.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
He's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Now, here's Watson. Another shot. Misses at the rim. Fires from deep. That one's all good. Now he's 3 for 5 from the field.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
Here's Smith. Pass to Watson to stop the run. The shot, no good. Here's B-Train, covered by Smith. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, easy call.
So people talk about a player's mileage limit. Do you think total games is the most accurate assessment?
I don't think so, Kevin.
What is it?
It's the amount of minutes that the players play.
Yeah.
I mean, there are plenty of studies out there that the teams are digging around on that when players reach. And trust me, they got to be lucky, but you're talking 35,000, 40,000 minutes in the league. That the body is just not capable at that point of replicating the things that it's done year in and year out. So forget about the games. Go to total minutes played. That's where you'll find the biggest fall off for some of your favorite players that have amused and entertained you for years.
Interesting.
And so he makes both from the line. Guys, nothing has really come easy for him today.
Yeah, definitely not their best basketball.
There's the pass to D. Out left to the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Thunder, and that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
It's his first trip to the line.
And his free throws are falling at a rate of only about 72% on the season. Not terrible, but listen, you obviously would expect him to do better.
No good on that one. And he can't make the second free throw either, missing both.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
D passes to primetime to end the drought. That's a miss. He's made one and missed one. Here's Thunder. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
There's 1:54 left here in the second.
And doesn't like how things are going right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit-chat with the team to settle down.
It's a free t-shirt. Make some noise.
1:51 left in the second quarter. And good that time. D's got five.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
Inside, here's Clark. Count that one. Clark's got his first points of the game.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Smith outside, pass to D. Missed inside.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Smith up top. He's been quiet so far, still no points in the game. 50 seconds left to play in the first half. Just five to shoot. Passes it to the general. Watson for three. And that one is off.
Things are going south right now. This is not the type of shooting that his teammates expect from him.
Thunder. Good. Thunder's got 5 points in the quarter.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And Jay gets the whistle that time.
Ramsey.
That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul. Watson. Shooting one.
He's checked in for Jay. We've got 22 seconds left in the first half.
And there hasn't been anything easy for him in this period.
No, I haven't seen him in comfortable spots, or at least spots we've seen in this offensive set that are allowing him to settle in.
Smith surveying the D, pass to Pinson. Over Edwards, off the mark from 16 feet out.
Well, he finds some space in that in-between gap there, Kevin. Too bad he can't release that one on target.
Smith.
And so it's the home team, finishing the quarter up by a whopping 24 points. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. We'll return shortly.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. Taking a look at this home squad, Kenny, what do you think?
Well, they just about ran their offense to perfection. They pounded the ball inside, and the entry feeds were on time and on the money. It was a clinic to watch. The second half is going to be no contest if they keep getting shots 8 feet and in.
Shaq, let's get your insight on the visiting team.
Well, first of all, as cold as they've been from the floor, I can't say I'm surprised by the score. You cannot shoot the ball that poorly and expect to be in the game early. They need better ball movement. If their offense stays this stagnant, they could forget about a comeback.
And that's a wrap for our halftime show. The third quarter just about to get started.
And end after a very lopsided first half. We'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. What a game we're seeing from B-Train.
And we saw just how important he is for this team in the first half. He was getting everyone involved.
Yeah, he knows his role. He's out there to distribute the ball, get his teammates involved. Nice job.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. We've got Jay. Thunder is out there with T. And there's B-Train. And it's Clark in at the three spot.
Plus eight in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Now the pass to Ramsey. Here's Thunder. It's hauled in by Watson. Smith on the wing. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. D passes to Smith. Smith right side. Shot clock at six. Back to Smith. From deep. Doesn't get it to drop for him.
He's not doing his team any good by taking shots from that range.
Yeah, the only thing that kind of shot helps with is your opponent's chance of winning.
Buries it from three-point range. 12 points for B-Train.
Now that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
And the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort. Got burned on that one.
The general, and right away they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
3 points.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Ramsey passes to Thunder. Just over a minute and a half have passed here in the third quarter. Here's B-Train, covered by Smith. And the wing jumper offline. To the paint, here's Smith. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Smith's got his first 2 points.
Coaching staff would like some more shots from that range.
Pass to Thunder. Passes it to Beecher. Shoots it up. That's good. Basket number five on a 5-for-8 night shooting.
Sweet to be a difference maker in the game, and he's been a great option for them on these possessions.
Smith outside. The pass to the general. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. The general's got his second basket of the night.
I do so enjoy watching a bounce pass executed that perfectly.
Timeout call.
Minutes gone now in the third quarter. To the middle. Rebound by Smith. Smith's got his fourth rebound in this one. There's the dish to Smith. Changes up. Basket good.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
Pass to Benson. Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Here's the general. He has 5. No good on the fadeaway.
Well, his poor shooting is a big reason that they're staring at this deficit right now. He needs to get on track if they're going to find a way to win.
Here's B-Train. 14 points for him. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
We've seen B-Train really have a great game.
Well, I hope this one is not to draw up a play, but to think about how they're going to defend that man. He's putting up some major numbers.
Says he's
all right, fans. Get on your feet and make some noise for T-Shirt Time.
Smith outside. Passes to the general. Brown outside. 5 on the clock. The general passes to Smith. And he stepped in the line, so they turn it over.
Tease ball.
This has been a one-sided affair.
Yeah, they've done a nice job of extending their lead and maintaining that intensity level.
Here's T from down in the low post. It goes. T's got his 3rd basket of the night right there.
Yeah, that play never gets old, Kevin. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
Smith the pass to Pinson. Now Smith, covered by Smith. Good work there as it goes. Smith's got his 2nd basket.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Pass to Edwards. Down low. Smith, no luck. Smith outside. It's stolen by Edwards. Here's Benson. Finished off the break. Baller's got 5.
And running with a full head of steam, but completely under control.
Yeah, you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before. Just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
Now, here's Brown. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. The general, the shot's good. Brown making the play.
And not a single point in the 1st quarter, but he's found his game, and you can tell he's got a bit of his swagger back.
Edwards passes to Smith. Edwards with it. Back to Smith. Kicks to McCallum. Shot clock at 5. Got a piece of it, and it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Thunder's checked in for T.
Thunder!
.40 seconds left in the 3rd quarter. Here's Smith.
and close on the shot, even with the foul. Now the two free throws. And he's got his first free throw of the game.
At the line, Smith. Oh,
take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good, Smith. And so he hits both. 34 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. And there's the pass to Edwards to the left wing. Clock at six. Puts it up. Rebound by Smith. Brown outside. No good that time. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. The home team delivering the blowout. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get started for the fourth quarter. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
So helpful to the offensive versatility when your bigs can create, freeing everybody up, and that cut was wide open.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. They've got Smith. The closer is out there with Smith. Then there's Brown, and it's the general in at the center position. Here's Edwards. And the layup falls.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Pass to Pinson. To the inside. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Brent, we have seen some international showcase games the last few years. Do you like that trend?
Oh, absolutely. I like the fact that our league, we know how global it is with how many players from different countries are represented throughout the rosters around the league. But for our game to travel around to London and to Mexico City and have an opportunity for those fans to see what NBA basketball is like, I think it's an absolute win for
the
NBA.
I'd like to see more.
Well, more time for those teams. The timing of some of those trips for some teams are a little bit tough in terms of the travel, but their appearances there mean so much more to grow the game globally.
Watson, he's checked in for Smith. That one is no good.
And just so frustrating for a team when you collectively go cold at the line. And that's happened to them here in the second half.
Now here's Fresh. From outside, off the mark. Watson surveying the D. Over Edwards. Watson's shot is off. Edwards with it. Picked up by Brown. Ramsey passes to Thunder. Passes it to Edwards. Just five on the clock. Out to the right wing. Here's Clark. No good from the wing. Clark's gone 1-3 from the field here. Smith the pass to Brown. And Brown throws it down.
Not getting old here, seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
Ramsey, covered by Smith. Here's Ramsey.
You know, Brent, how candid can players be in their answers in the post
game interviews about what has happened or what they're feeling at that time. In other words, is there a danger to being, you know, being too honest as a player?
Taking two shots.
There could be, Kevin. I mean, anytime you express some of your vulnerabilities, and if it's done at the right time, somebody's going to take advantage of it. What we've seen over the past couple years is, forget about when it is that the media is asking you questions. Most players are taking it to their social media accounts where they're able to get the message out without being baited by somebody with regards to a question. They can expound on whatever it is that they're feeling at that time, and that helps them to control the messaging a little bit more. And I think that trend is going to continue and continue to grow.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. D passes to Brown. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. It's Clark with the rebound.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And the rejection by Smith. Pass to D. Right wing, Watson for three. That shot, no good.
Well, both him and the team seem to be off their game right now, and the frustration is clearly mounting as the clock is winding down.
Now, here is Smith. Here's D. No good. Here's B-Train. Brent, when we talk about home court advantage, do you feel it's the same as it used to be? It has that same impact?
I do think it's still hugely important, Kevin. It's less important when there's a team that has been together for a long time and has proven that they can take their wares on the road and come home with a victory. But it absolutely gives you a level of comfort as a player to get into your routine, to be at a place that seems familiar. Something deep down psychologically helps every member of that team being at home.
Down to five on the shot clock. Here's D. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Here's B-Train. Pass to T. Three-pointer, and the three ball is good.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooters.
T's gone 4 for 4 shooting tonight. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
And Watson has it in the corner. Passes it to the general. Here's D. No good, unable to end this run.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
And the pass to B-Train. From 15 feet away, it's hauled in by Watson. Watson's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Knocked loose. For so long, the U.S. has been the country to beat in international basketball play. But there are some big-time challengers around the globe emerging.
Well, Serbia and Spain continue to be competition that the U.S. takes extremely seriously. And I'm not saying they don't take everybody that they step on the floor against with tremendous amount of respect. We know from years in the past that Argentina had its golden age with the players around Manu Ginobili and Oberto and Nocioni, but that seemed to be a timing thing for the Argentinian national team. Spain and Serbia will continue to be impressive and continue to push USA basketball in these international tournaments and Olympic play.
Here's the general. Let's it go from 14. That's not going to go. He's 4 for 10. The general's gone 40% from the floor in 10 attempts. Pass to Ramsey. tee. He's covered by Watson. Tee the pass to B-Train. The tray. That shot is in, just like six others have been for him. He's shooting 7 for 15.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
It's one thing to have teams shoot a bunch of threes, but with this team being that hot defensively, you gotta chase them away from anywhere near that line.
Now, here's Brown. The three. Watson's shot is off.
And not a way to get out of a funk. He needs to be looking for good, solid, more efficient shots, not the wild one he took there.
Here's B-Train. Passes it to Ramsey. Let's a floater go. It's not going to go for him. Looking to get it going. Good as the jump shot falls. Here's B-Train. There's 18 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And so the home crowd treated to a win. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a supreme effort. It just felt like once they had that lead and it was comfortable, they were not going to relinquish it.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. We'll see you next time.